Don't let me down. Don't let your family down. Don't let all these people down and all the people across the world. I don't want to go here because everybody else does. And I was close with the man. I was his champion in Florida Championship Wrestling. But don't let your dad down.
Hey, Drew. Look, you ain't got to be a prick, all right? And look, what in the world makes you think if he doesn't accept my challenge for WrestleMania, it's going to be you and me? Because we've done this dance twice, and if I remember correctly, you lost.
We both know there was outside reasons why I lost those matches. But is this a case of the pot calling the kettle black? Didn't you lose to him 3 times? Okay, I'm going to say something nice. You know, I heard what you said last Monday. I heard what Roman had to say. Ignore him. If you're that insecure, I will tell you to your face. I'll look you in the eye. You have done an amazing job with that title. You have worked your butt off every single week to make that mean something. That is the true Workhorse Championship right there. You did that. Ignore what he has to say. Ignore what everyone else has to say. This is a case when you fight for this title. You know what happens in Roman's matches? No one wants to fight for it anymore because we know the finish. His family are going to interfere every single time. They did it to me. They did it to Cody. They've done it to multiple people. This is a case of me, the best man, win. Except in my case, of course, when I was screwed a couple of times.
Okay.
Cody, I'm not finished yet, please.
It's rolling, Cole.
If you were a real workhorse, they would have shot you dead after the first injury. Now, about 17 injuries later, it's time for somebody to do the job. You've done an amazing, amazing job taking the title this far, but it's time for Drew McIntyre to take it from here.
Oh, no! And Cody Rhodes now trying to unload on McIntyre after McIntyre took a cheap shot on Seth Rollins.
Drew McIntyre is making a living out of attacking hurt people.
I've given you Nia Jax for the championship at the Elimination Chamber. That works for you? Then please, let's keep the show going. This is not the time. Let us...
Not so fast. General Manager Pierce, because marching to the ring, the irresistible force Nia Jax, who last week on this program annihilated Rhea Ripley. And here we go, and the fight's on. Why wait to Elimination Chamber? Oh, and Nia Jax just blasting into Pierce's. Pierce is calling for security, and Ripley and Nia Jax beating the hell out of each other.
Rhea Ripley's throwing bombs on Nia Jax.
And now a security trying to separate these women. Nia Jax screaming at the champion. Deep disdain between these two. Jax blowing through everybody to flatten Ripley. And now she's assaulting security officers. And you thought McIntyre was in hot water. Wait until we see how Nia Jax is addressed by our general manager. But before that,
second rope.
And an annihilator to Rhea Ripley.
Sternum to spine.
Rhea Ripley demanded Nia Jax. Pat, I am not quite sure that was the right move, despite the fact the Eradicator, the Women's World Champion Rhea Ripley, has been nearly unstoppable.
This would have been a night that's remembered forever.
Yeah, especially in this town. And Miz, looking to put McDonough away, perhaps with a skull-crushing finale. And McDonough able to sling Miz, and now McDonough sent outside the ring. And Miz now driving Dominic right down to the floor.
Dominic took the shot for JD.
And Miz Sends McDonough flying.
R-Truth.
A goofy R-Truth is a...
brand new merch for you, Dom.
Giving Dom a new t-shirt, but it's like Dom's in a straitjacket.
No, it's brand new merch.
And Miz makes it pay. See? The awesome truth are awesome. And R-Truth looks a bit upset that Miz took out Mysterio. But Truth's the dummy that put the t-shirt on Dom in the first place. McDonough, top rope. We're going to take Miz out. Hook of the leg for the win on Miz, who kicks out at two. R-Truth was wearing a road crew vest.
Of course.
And
flashing some
Look at this is a J.D. McDonough's cut of the t-shirt sales.
R-Truth hustling those shirts. J.D. McDonough said, don't mind if I do.
JD will take the money, won't he? And Miz from behind! Scott Hudson finale! What?
I'm gonna beat you so bad that you wish yourself back to the good old days where people couldn't tell you and your brother apart.
Now, Jey Uso's not going to be disrespected. He takes Gunther down, and of course, Kaiser and Vinci, the henchmen from Imperium, all over Jey Uso.
Outnumbered.
And finally, the New Day, of course, who have their own issues with Imperium, coming to Jey Uso's aid. Gunther, Kaiser, and Vinci will retreat.
What you want? Huh? Why'd you stand when we got 3-on-3?
We've seen him win all kinds of matches with this move. It's called the keg stand. Kairi Sane, though, intercepts.
Knocked off the tap.
And Katana Chance crashed and burned, and Caden Carter sent into the steel steps. And the kick to the head, tag to Kairi Sane. Here comes the double team. The Kabuki Warriors have been so successful with this. Kairi Sane from the top rope. Insane elbow! And with that, Sane will go into the cover and retain the tag team titles. Oh, McIntyre! Drew McIntyre! Pounding away on Cody Rhodes.
This cheap shot artist.
This dangerous vendetta he's had against all he believed have cost him the world championship. And a claymore to Cody Rhodes, who just went through a bull rope match, got blinded by mist. For Drew McIntyre, he said before, I'm not a bad guy, I'm a hero. I think McIntyre's delusional. Born to be the greatest of all time. This is where I draw the line. Can't stop my shine. They know it's my time. Let the world know I've arrived. I'm on the rise. Unstoppable.